Welcome, everyone. According to the textbook that we are following on, which is Microwave Engineering by D.M. Bozar, the following part that we are going to discuss is other types of microwave diodes. In the previous videos, we have discussed the Venn diode and the varactor diodes. Now, in the textbook, there are other four types of microwave diodes, which are GaN diodes, impact diodes, and parity diodes, and tunnel diodes. These types of diodes have been discussed very briefly in Microwave Engineering by D.M. Bozar. So I have preferred to go into more references about microwave devices. So I returned to microwave semiconductor devices by Yang Sun and microwave active devices and circuits for communication by Vera, RF and microwave semiconductor devices handbook by Golo, and microwave devices and circuits by Liao, and microwave devices, circuits and subsystems for communication engineering by Clover, Pink and Chibok. All these textbooks I have selected some parts from this textbook regarding to these four types of diodes, and we are going to start with the GaN diode. Effectively, the GaN diode is misleading name because it is not a real diode. Usually, the diode that we know is PN junction in somehow. However, GaN diode is only M. Maybe it is defined as a diode because it is two-terminal device, but actually it is not diode. It is simply an N layer between two N plus layers. The key idea of the GaN diode is composed of gallium arsenide or indium phosphide material, or what we are going or what we are seeing. IV semiconductor material. We know that if we have made an alloy from atoms with three free electrons and other atom from five free electrons on the last orbit, so the alloy from three atoms and five atoms will introduce something similar to the silicon and germanium, which had four atoms in the outer orbit. These alloys, which are called IIIV alloys, an example for this alloy is gallium arsenide, indium phosphide. These are some types of IIIV alloys. So the basic idea, the GaN diode is made of N layer from IIIV alloy semiconductor. It cannot be made from silicon. It cannot be made from germanium. So it should be from an alloy. And we will see why. So GaN diode is not a PN junction, as it is composed of only N-type semiconductor material. GaN diode is based on what is called transfer electron effect. Effectively, transfer electron effect is a main property of IIIV semiconductor alloys. The basic idea of transfer electron effect is that we know that in semiconductor we have valence band and conduction band. If the electron in the valence band, it does not conduct any electric current. If it is in conduction band, it will conduct the current. The main property of IIIV semiconductor alloys is that the conduction band is composed of two or different bands. So we have low energy conduction band and high energy conduction band. I'm going to discuss this property in the following slide. So at least let us say that now. Gandalf typically used gallium arsenide or indium phosphide material, and especially dope bulk form. Now, let us go to discuss the energy band of triple IIV semiconductor alloy. As I said, in triple IIV semiconductor alloy, we have different conduction bands. We have conduction band and we have higher energy conduction band. The main property of alloys like gallium arsenide or indium phosphide is that the mobility of the electrons in the lower conduction band is higher than the mobility of the electrons in higher conduction band. Once again, the electron mobility in the lower conduction band is greater than the mobility in the higher conduction band. This means that if the electrons are in the lower conduction band and I apply the voltage, applied voltage means that I applied energy on the electrons, the electron will move with speed according to high mobility. Means that as I'm increasing the voltage, the speed of the electron will increase proportional to high value of mobility. However, if the electrons are transferred to the higher energy band, they are moving with lower mobility. It means that if the electrons are transferred to the higher energy band, the speed of the electron will be decreased. And if the speed of the electron is decreased, it means that the current will be decreased, not increased. So, if we are looking for the IV characteristic of a symbol in a bulk of gallium arsenide, for example, at the beginning, at voltage equals zero, there is no energy at all, so there is no current. So at the voltage equals zero, there is no current. Now, if I have increased the voltage on the sample, it means that the electrons will have some energy. So this energetic electrons will move to the conduction band, the lower energy conduction band, and in the conduction band it will move through the sample with the mobility of the lower conduction band. As I'm increasing the applied voltage, the number of the electron which will transfer from the valence band to the conduction band will increase, and the velocity or the speed of the electrons will increase proportional to the mobility of the lower conduction band. So in this case, as I'm increasing the applied voltage, the forward current will increase slightly linear. Alright? After a while, almost all the free electrons in the valence band will be transferred completely to the lower conduction band. Now, if I have increased the applied voltage, if I have increased the energy on the sample, some of the electrons in the lower conduction band will be transferred to the higher conduction band. But the higher conduction band has lower mobility than the lower conduction band. The higher conduction band has lower mobility than the lower conduction band. This means that the electrons which has been transferred from the lower conduction band to the higher conduction band will be moving at a lower speed. Will be moving at a lower speed. So the average speed of the all electrons now will be decreased by increasing the voltage. The average speed of all the electrons will be decreased by increasing the voltage. If I'm saying that the speed of the electron is decreased, it means that the current is going to be decreased. So, as long as I'm increasing the voltage, I'm transferring more and more electrons from the lower conduction band to the higher conduction band. It means that more and more electrons will move in a lower speed. So, more and more the average speed will be decreased. So, in this case, the current will be decreased. So, the first stage, the electrons are moving from the valence band to the lower conduction band and are transferred through the sample. So, the current increasing is increasing with the applied voltage. Now, in the second stage, the electrons are moving from the lower conduction band to the higher conduction band, and the higher conduction band has smaller speed, so the average speed is decreased in the second stage. After a certain voltage, almost all the electrons in the lower conduction band will be transferred completely to the higher conduction band. Now, all the electrons are moving with the lower mobility of the higher conduction band. Now, if I increased the applied voltage, I'm increasing the energy on the electrons, I'm increasing the speed of the electrons, but with the mobility of the higher conduction band. So, in this case, after this point, increasing the voltage will introduce increasing in the current, but once again, with the mobility of the higher conduction band, not the lower conduction band. So, the slope of this part should be less than the slope of this part. Effectively, the right one looks like this. Here, the slope, mu1, the mobility of the lower conduction band. Here, some of the electrons are moving with mu1 and some of the electrons moving with mu2. So, until this point, then all the electrons will be moving with the mobility mu2 of the higher conduction band, which is less than the mobility of the lower conduction band. So, this is effectively the IV characteristic of sample of any type of gallium arsenide, or generally speaking, IIIV semiconductor material, because almost all IIIV semiconductor material have two conduction or two levels for conduction band. One, a lower conduction band with high mobility and higher conduction band with lower mobility. This is called transfer electron effect, because actually the electrons are transferred from the valence band to the lower conduction band and from the conduction lower conduction band to the higher conduction band. And in the transfer region here, the differential relation between the current and the voltage is negative. So, here, delta I by delta V is positive. Here, delta I by delta V is positive. But here, in this region, in the transfer electron effect, delta I by delta V is negative. Delta I by delta V is negative. It means that the AC resistance or the dynamic resistance in this region is negative. This means that actually the magnitude of the resistance is positive. The magnitude I over V is positive because the current is positive over the voltage is positive. So I over V is positive. But the dynamic resistance is the derivative of the current, delta I by delta V. Here, delta I by delta V is negative. So, the dynamic resistance or the AC resistance in this region is negative resistance. So, we have a negative resistance part in the region from V1 to V2, where V1 to V2 is the starting from the transfer from the lower conduction band to the higher conduction band until all the electrons are transferred to the higher conduction band. Usually, we use this sample of N-type gallium arsenide at this point of voltage. as the starting of the negative differential resistance. So we use it in the negative resistance region such that the effect of the GaN diode or this sample, it would be equivalent to a negative resistance. Negative resistance here is a basic idea for many microwave circuits. If you remember, we said that the reflection coefficient, for example, gamma, is Z load minus Z naught over Z load plus Z load. Assume that Z naught is 50 ohm. For any positive value of Z load starting from 0 to infinity, the value of the reflection coefficient, it would be greater than or equal 0 and less than or equal unity. We say that if we say gamma equals Z load minus Z naught over Z load plus Z naught. If Z load, assume that it is real, is greater than or equal 0 and less than or equal infinity, the value of gamma, if Z load is 0, it would be greater than or equal minus 1. If it is infinity, less than 1. So, generally speaking, the magnitude of gamma is greater than or equal 0 and less than or equal 1. The question now, what will be the situation if Z load is negative resistance? If it is negative resistance, this would be, say, minus A minus Z naught over minus A plus Z naught. If we look at this value and we take the magnitude, if the value of the resistance is negative, we can find that gamma as a magnitude is greater than unity. Because here the numerator would be A squared plus Z squared. Sorry, it would be A plus Z. And here the numerator is Z minus A. So here the numerator is greater than the denominator. What is mean of the reflection is greater than unity? Means that if I have a negative resistance, Z load negative resistance equal minus A, then the reflection coefficient is greater than or V reflected as a magnitude, it would be greater than V incident. V reflected would be greater than V incident. V reflected is greater than V incident. It means that I have amplified the incident signal. So effectively, any negative resistance will correspond to some sort of amplification. And this effectively is the basic idea of any amplifier, either microwave or RF amplifier. So if I have a negative resistance effect, I can use this negative resistance effect for amplification. Once again, if I'm talking about a resonance circuit, LC circuit, for example, this is ideal resonance circuit, but practical resonance circuit, I usually have an additional resistance which corresponds to the losses. And with these losses, we'll introduce the quality factor of this resonator. If I have switched on This resonant circuit with a battery, for example, this resonant circuit will introduce damping oscillation. Why damping? Because of the resistance. Now, if I have added a resistance, a negative resistance here, R minus R here, such that it will compensate the losses in the resonant circuit, this will introduce a constant oscillation. So, the idea of negative resistance is quite useful for introducing amplification, is quite useful for introducing stable oscillation and other applications. So, the transfer electron effect of the IIIV semiconductor material, IIIV, which is the gallium, IV, which is the arsenide. So this IIIV alloy, the transfer electron effect, which is based on the two conduction band here, which introduce the negative resistance in the sample, is the basic idea for the GaN effect, which has been discovered by a scientist called GaN. And this is a basic idea of the GaN diode. This GaN diode can be used as an amplifier. This GaN diode can be used as a negative resistance in a resonator to introduce stable oscillation. So this is very important characteristic. Now we have two mechanisms for oscillations in the GaN diode. The first mechanism is called domain decomposition in GaN diode. The basic idea of domain decomposition in the GaN diode is that I'm going to apply electric field on the N-type sample of the GaN diode such that it is quite close to be in the negative resistance region. In this case, due to any perturbation in the crystals of this semiconductor piece, there will be the electric field is increasing in some region more than the other region. Increasing the electric field, it means that the velocity of the electrons will be less at this region. So, the electrons here are moving in a fast way. At the same time, in the perturbation region, the electrons are slow. So, in this case, this is similar to some cars are moving in a road and are moving with high speed, and we have a car at the front of them moving with a slow speed. So, almost all of the car will be accumulated behind the car with a small speed. Accumulation the electrons or accumulation these cars, accumulation the electron will increase the electric field, will introduce electric field, will increase the electric field. Increasing the electric field will decrease more and more the velocity of or the speed of the electrons. Decreasing the electrons will increase the accumulation of the electrons. So, at any perturbation, there will be accumulation of the positive charge at a certain region and negative charge at this region. This accumulation will increase the electric field at this point. Increasing the electric field will decrease the speed more and more. So, decreasing the speed will increase the accumulation more and more. Increasing the accumulation of the electron will increase the electric field. Increasing the electric field will decrease the speed, increasing the accumulation. This is what we are calling that there is a domain of electron has been created. After a while, almost all the electric field will be concentrated at the domain, and there is no electric field at all at the sample. And this domain will be moving with the speed of small velocity of the domain. This domain will be moving from the negative side to the positive side with such small speed until it reaches to the positive side. Once it reaches to the positive side, it will be bench off or will be explode inside the positive side, such that all the negative charge will be neutralized with the positive side. At this moment, there is no domain, and the electric field will be distributed once again along all the sample, and due to any disturbance in the crystal, which is already has been introduced before, another domain will be starting once again, and this domain will move and will increase gradually and will move with small speed until it will be bench off once again on the positive side, and this will be repeated. So if we have just connected positive and negative DC between any sample from gallium arsenide sample, the output current will be seen at the oscillator or at the oscilloscope looks like this. And if we have amplified this region, we will see that we have nearly sinusoidal wave in this region. So effectively, this is the average DC current, but this average DC current is combined with an AC signal with continuous frequency. This has been discovered by Gunn and has been explained by the transfer electron effect. So effectively, just connecting a piece of N-type gallium arsenide will introduce such oscillations. And this oscillation, the frequency of this oscillation depends on the length of this gallium arsenide piece and the speed of the electron domain at the highest voltage. So it depends on two parameters. The first parameter is the length and the speed of the domain. So effectively, the periodic time here, T, is actually, or tau here, tau, is L, the length of the sample, over the velocity of the domain. So this frequency depends on the geometry of this GaN diode, and it is fixed for a specific length. So this is not quite useful to introduce microwave oscillator, because it depends on the structure of the GaN diode itself. But this is a certain type of oscillation which is called domain decomposition oscillation in a GaN diode. And the most commonly used regime in GaN diode is the domain regime. This regime is characterized by the existence of dipole domain formed during the oscillation period. Another regime is that instead of constructing a domain, we are going to make use of the negative resistance behavior in the region between the first mobility and the second mobility. This negative resistance oscillation in this region, the GaN diode is equivalent to a negative resistance. So if I have added to a resonator circuit, I can compensate the losses in the resonator circuit, and the oscillation in the resonator circuit will be sustained at a constant value. So the negative resistance oscillation, the GaN diode has an IV characteristic that exhibits negative differential resistance or negative slope that can be used to generate RF power directly from DC source when properly biased. The region of negative differential resistance corresponds to the operating point of the device. So the operating point here is the midpoint of the negative resistance. Generally speaking, the GaN diodes can produce continuous power up to several hundred milliwatts at frequencies from 1 GHz to up to 200 GHz. So it is very simple device to as a microwave or millimeter wave oscillators with efficiency ranging from 5% to 15%. The basic idea of negative resistance oscillation is that we are inserting the GaN diode inside a cavity, and we are going to make use of the negative resistance of this GaN diode at the operating region to compensate the losses inside the cavity, which is equivalent to the resistance of the cavity. Effectively, in this case, there is no domain is formed inside the GaN diode. That's why we are saying that this limited or limiting accumulation of bulk charge regime. Limiting accumulation of bulk charge regime. We are not introducing accumulated domain. So in this case, there is no domain is formed inside the GaN diode. The voltage frequency is so large such that the voltage drop in the GaN diode passes negative differential resistance area faster than compared to the time tau, which is the time of the formulation of the domain. So the oscillation here going from positive to negative is much faster than the required time to compose a domain, and this domain is moving from the cathode to the end. The domain has no sufficient time to form and dynamic volt ampere characteristic coincide with the characteristic of the drift speed VD as a function of the electric field. And the VD as a function of the electric field here, the velocity is decreasing with increasing the electric field. Effectively, the resonant circuit can be represented as an RLC. And the basic idea of the GaN diode here is to be a negative resistance in combined with the resonance circuit such that to compensate the positive resistance of the resonance circuit such that the losses due to the capital R will be compensated by the negative resistance of the GaN diode negative R. And there's RF choke coil between the DC voltage and the resonant circuit to avoid that the RF signal is referred or returned back to the DC voltage. So the RF signal here will go in the other side. As a practical implementation for such GaN diode oscillator, here is a rectangular cavity. And this rectangular cavity here is a GaN diode. And the GaN diode is biased through a via, and this via is connected to RF choke coil here, and this RF choke coil here is connected to the DC voltage, and this DC voltage between here is the positive of the DC voltage, and here is the ground, and this screw, for example, is used for fine tuning for the resonant circuit, and the output of this resonator will be connected to a waveguide to introduce an output for the RF signal from this waveguide. So the RF signal introduced inside this cavity will not pass through the choke but will pass through the waveguide. And here is a practical example for a GaN diode resonator oscillator. And these are the tuning screw. And here is the DC biasing network or the DC biasing, and inside this, there is the GaN diode. So this is basically based on the negative resistance oscillation. Oscillator circuits using GaN diodes require high quality resonant circuit or cavity which is often tuned mechanically. Electronic tuning by bias adjustment is limited to 1% or less. However, we can improve this tuning adjustment limit by adding a varactor diode, which we have discussed in the previous video, are sometimes included in the resonant circuit to provide a greater range of electronic tuning. GaN diode sources are used extensively in low-cost applications such as traffic radars, motion detectors, or door openers, or security alarms. So effectively, it is very simple and low-cost RF and microwave oscillator. So it can be used in low-cost application and test and measurement system. This is briefly what is mean by GaN diode, what is mean by transfer electron effect, how we can use GaN diode as an oscillator, either by using the domain decomposition or by negative resistance oscillation. This was a brief discussion about GaN diode. In the following video, we are going to talk about InBAT diode.